Loch Ness, a beautiful but forbidding lake in the Scottish Highlands. The first recorded sighting of the Loch Ness monster goes all the way back to the 6th century, when an Irish monk was said to have chastised the vicious creature and ordered it back into the depths. But it wasn't until a string of sightings in the 1930s that hunting for the Loch Ness monster began in earnest. London tabloids printed eyewitness accounts, and they desperately wanted a photo to go with the stories. In 1934, a London surgeon named R. Kenneth Wilson provided this snapshot. The image was immediately dubbed the surgeon's photo. It was printed and reprinted, appearing in countless newspapers and books, and the Loch Ness legend continued to grow. Then, nearly 60 years later, a man named Christian Sperling made a stunning revelation. The photo was the brainchild of his stepfather, Duke Wetherill, a flamboyant big game hunter the Daily Mail had sent to Loch Ness to capture Nessie on film. According to Sperling, when Duke failed to come up with a photo, the paper fired him. So Wetherill decided to settle the score. Wetherill took a toy submarine, fashioned a Nessie-shaped head and neck, and launched the monster in the shallows of Loch Ness. He took the famous photo and later convinced the London surgeon to claim it as his own.